So today we're going to be talking about Facebook ads tips just for your campaign, how you should approach this, the best way to approach this. Okay, so here are different ad types. So you have the sponsored post on the left and then the right-hand column on the right. So the sponsored post will show up in their news feed, but then the right-hand column will stay on the right side. So it's kind of more like a Google ad. It's more of a traditional digital ad. They're very similar in terms of how you can create demographics. And so let's go on to targeting your audience. This is definitely a key to Facebook ads. And so on the left, this is kind of the portal that you'll see when you go to boost your ad. Kind of at the end of the presentation here, I'll do a live demo of kind of going through exactly what you need to do for that. General specifics, you can target by location, city, state, country. You can target by gender. You can target by interest. And this is very, very broad. So it could take you a while just to kind of figure out exactly each one. You should kind of already have an idea of who you would want to target based on their interests and behaviors. So behaviors is kind of a little bit different than interests. Behaviors could range from someone visiting your website to how much money they spend on a particular item. You can target by connections, people who already know you, or you can exclude any of these behaviors or targets as well. So you can get very minute. You can go from an audience of 1 million down to just a couple thousand. And this kind of will determine exactly how your ad does, as if you're targeting somebody that's in their mid-20s preparing for Social Security, they're probably not going to be as interested as somebody that's, in their 60s. So this is kind of the key to Facebook ads is targeting. How do you write effective ad copy? First, select your target audience. So before you even think about what you're going to put down for an ad, you need to think about what audience you want to target. This will determine every course of action that you take for writing your ad, for us helping you design it, for how much money you're going to put into it. It just really depends on what you want your target audience to be. One key for each of the audiences that you want to, so you want to write a different ad for a male audience and a female audience potentially. So you need to keep that in mind when you're writing effective ad copy. So it just depends on exactly who you're targeting, and it's really key to get very specific with your copy. Your copy should work with your image. So if you have copy about a fishing retreat, but then you have an image of a golf club, it just doesn't really fit. So you need to keep that in mind. Keep it short and simple, easy to understand. Usually, I know for journalism and newspapers and for ads in newspapers, we try to keep it 8th grade level or easier. Social media, I've heard 5th grade reading level, so it's just you need to keep it easy to understand, straightforward. Keep it short, less than just a sentence or two. You don't want to have a paragraph. Facebook will kind of throttle your ad depending on how much copy is in it, and they also scan for copy in images. So if you have a paragraph or two in the image and you think that, okay, since I have such a short copy, but then I put it all in the image, I'll be okay. Well, Facebook actually searches images for copy. So they'll kind of make your ad maybe even more expensive because of the more information that you put into it. And your audience will probably just scroll right past it because they don't have enough time to sit there for, a minute or two to read an ad and try to figure out exactly what it means. One thing that I like to do is look for examples and inspiration. I'll show some examples here in a little bit, but just looking at other agents can be really helpful. You all are experts in your fields. That's why you do what you do. That's why you're an independent agent. But you need to keep in mind copy. If you find a Coca-Cola ad that you really like, you like how they laid it out, you like how just the graphical elements were in it, you can take that and transform that into an ad for 401k very easily. You can turn it into an ad for annuities or life insurance. You just have to keep in mind that we're here to help you do that. If you need help with copy, we can definitely do that. If you need help with the design of the Facebook ad, we can definitely help with that. So just keep in mind, we're here to help you, and sometimes it just takes a little bit of inspiration to get going. And one key thing, test to see what works. If an ad for one set of individuals does very well, then rerun it. If an ad for a particular group does terrible, you spend $100 and you don't get one lead off of it, maybe it's because the ad was bad or your target audience was bad. Most of the time, it's not because Facebook ads does not work, because Facebook ads works. You just have to have the right copy message for your intended audience. Tips to create the best call to actions. Eventually, you want to not only have good copy, but if you have fantastic copy and nobody does anything with your ad, then it's kind of a waste of time. Only have one call to action. So whatever Facebook ad you have, just have it very specific. You need to provide value. If I see an ad and I don't think it's worth my time, I'm not going to do anything with it. Be upfront and clear with your messaging. Don't try to hide anything. We don't want to overload them. We want to create urgency, but we want to be upfront with what we offer without trying to hide anything. We want to be urgent. We want to create a sense of, okay, I need to act on. Then one key with the call to action is it's essentially in the pinnacle of your elevator pitch. A Facebook ad is essentially a refinement of that elevator pitch. And once again, we all need to test. So maybe one call to action, maybe your phone number works on one set of individuals, but then maybe a call to action to a landing page works on another set of individuals. So here are two examples. On the left, we have an ad for student loans. And then on the right, it's a more of a business to business ad, but it's very quick, very informative. As you can see with both these ads, the messaging, the image, and the call to action all tie together. They all work simultaneously to kind of focus on one goal. There's minimal copy, it's very simple, it's eye-catching. So let's talk about maximizing our ROI. So here is one company with very similar body copy, the same call to action. This is all for the same campaign. So this is nine different ads that they used for this free 14-day trial. And this is kind of the same mentality that we need to have if we really want to get serious with our Facebook advertising. It's a lot of work, but if you do it and you're committed to it, it will pay off. So just to close out, really to get a good advertisement campaign going, you need to be consistent. If you run an ad for one day and it doesn't work, and then you just give up. Well, sometimes it takes 3, 4, 6 weeks for these ad campaigns to really get going. Some say it takes between 3 and 7 times for somebody to actually see an ad before they interact with it. That's with any medium. If you're running the same ad over and over and over again, you'll get worse results. When consumers see the same thing over and over and over again, they'll just skip it. How many times have you driven to work and seen the exact same billboards over and over and over again? Do you really look at them or interact with them in any way? It's key to have fresh content, even if it's just the same copy, same everything, but different image. That will change everything. And rotate your ads. You can definitely reuse your ads. It's not good to use the same ad over and over and over again, but it is good to practice. Okay, I ran this ad 2 months ago, now I can rerun it. It's also very good to align your ad design with your brand. If you don't have a brand yet, call us. Tasia and I can help you with that, with your logo design. It really helps to have a common theme for everything that you do. If your landing page doesn't look like the Facebook ad, they might get confused and then not do anything. Or if your landing page is confusing or not attractive, or if it's just difficult to read, you'll lose potential clients. So it's all about having that same brand throughout the process. And have you tested what works? So that's definitely a key for anything in marketing, but really for Facebook ads, it's all about testing. So here I'm gonna kind of go into a live demo. So here we go. So this is the IMS page. So just to a quick overview on how to start an ad. So I'm going to use a previous Facebook post, DOL post. So if I look at the bottom right half of the post, there's an option to boost post. And this will pull up that kind of screenshot that I had at the towards the beginning of this webinar. So you can do target, age, people who like your page, living locations, people who like your page and their friends. So this is kind of right now, this is selecting who I want to target. So if I go into edit, this pulls up everything else. So I can look at location, including interest, demographics. So if I go into demographics, I can go by education level, their financial status, their income, net worth, their life events, if they're married or not, if they own a home, where they work. For their interests, we go entertainment, family and relationships. And so if they're dating, if they have a family, if they're a father, if they're a mother, what types of hobbies they have, if they're interested in technology, it just goes on and on and on and on. Behaviors, we have if people are on their anniversary or with their behaviors in the past, it gets pretty granular. So you can include as many as you want specifically or exclude. So right now, like for this example, we're going with an audience of 1.3 million people, but if, that's just the state of Nebraska. So if I You can narrow it down pretty quickly. So if I just go Omaha, so that brings it down to 650,000. You can edit the size of the radius that you're choosing. So that brings it down to 600,000. And then it just goes on from there. We're more than willing to help you design a Facebook ad, help you out in that way. Just kind of anything that we can do to help you out. You're also free to contact me. Any questions, call in. My email is josh@imzinc.com, but you're more than willing to just contact the whole creative team. Thanks for attending the webinar today. I appreciate your time, and we look forward to helping you grow your business.